गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम अगेन। इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई वाज गिविंग सम इम्पॉर्टेंट नोट्स। इन दैट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट होमिनाइड्स। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस होमिनिड। सो प्लीज राइट होमिनिड्स बिटवीन 5.6 माया एंड 1.8 माया होमिनिड्स हैव इवॉल्व फ्रॉम होमिनाइड्स एंड शेयर सर्टेन कॉमन फीचर एंड हैव मेजर डिफरेंसेस एज वेल। द डिफरेंसेस वर यू कैन कैटेगराइज पॉइंट वाइज यू हैव टू राइट इट वन बाय वन। वन होमिनिड्स एंड होमिनाइड्स। फर्स्ट होमिनाइड्स। होमिनाइड्स हैव ए स्मॉलर ब्रेन। होमिनिड्स हैव ए लिटिल बिगर ब्रेन देन होमोनाइड्स। सेकेंड दे आर क्वाड्रेप्ट्स वॉकिंग ऑन ऑल फोर लेग्स बट होमिनिड्स हु हैज डेवलप्ड हैव एन अपराइट पोस्चर एंड बाइपीडल लोकोमोशन वॉकिंग ऑन टू फीट। थर्ड इन होमोनाइड्स दे हैव फ्लेक्सिबल फॉर लिम्स एंड मार्क डिफरेंसेस इन द हैंड। होमिनिड्स दे हैव फ्लेक्सिबल दे हैव फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी इन हैंड लेग एंड फिंगर विच हेल्प देम टू मेक टूल एंड वीपन्स। इट मीन्स होमो हैबिलिसिस बिलोंग टू होमिनिड। इट वॉज फर्स्ट टूल मेकर एज यू नो। तो द क्वालिटी वॉज सिमिलरली लाइक होमोनिड। ओके वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अगेन टॉपिक। होमिनिड्स फर्दर सब डिवाइडेड इंटू टू ब्रांच नोन एज ऑस्ट्रेलोपिथेकस एंड होमो। ईच ऑफ दीज इन टर्न इंक्लूड सेवरल स्पेसीज। द मेजर डिफरेंसेज बिटवीन ऑस्ट्रेलोपिथेकस एंड होमो रिलेट टू ब्रेन साइज जा एंड टीथ। द ऑस्ट्रेलोपिथेकस हैव स्मॉलर ब्रेन साइज द हेवियर जा एंड लार्जर टीथ देन द होमो। इट मीन्स होमो वॉज अपडेट फॉर्म ऑफ ऑस्ट्रेलोपिथेकस। आई थिंक दिस अपडेट वर्ड यू कैन फेमिलियर। इट वॉज डेवलप्ड होमो वॉज डेवलप्ड देन ऑस्ट्रेलोपिथेकस। द नेम ऑस्ट्रेलोपिथेकस कम्स फ्रॉम लैटिन वर्ड ऑस्ट्रल मीनिंग साउदर्न एंड ग्रीक वर्ड पिथेकोस मीनिंग एप। होमो होमो इज लैटिन वर्ड मीनिंग मैन। ऑल्दो देयर वर वुमेन एज वेल साइंटिस्ट डिस्टिंग्विश अमंग सेवरल टाइप ऑफ होमो। द नेम्स असाइंड टू दीज स्पीसीज आर डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम व्हाट आर रिगार्डेड एज देयर टिपिकल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक। सो फॉसिल्स आर क्लासिफाइड एज होमो हैबिलिसिस द टूल मेकर, होमो इरेक्टस द अपराइट मैन एंड होमो सेपियंस द थिंकिंग मैन। एंड वी हैव टू थिंक अबाउट द पॉजिटिव फीडबैक मैकेनिज्म टू द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग्स अर्ली ह्यूमन। फर्स्ट सम ऑफ द फीचर्स आर डेवलपमेंट इन द एनाटॉमी ऑफ अर्ली ह्यूमन बींग फेवर्ड आर सेव्ड देम टू बिकम मॉडर्न ह्यूमन बींग्स। These developments are together called positive feedback mechanism. Bipedalism or upright walking. Bipedalism or upright walking help to use less energy for hunting, carrying infant, making and using weapons. This was the very important. It was the greatest change. Flexibility in hands. Flexibility in hands and finger enable hand to be freed to carrying infant or object. In turn, as a hand were used more and more, running become easy. That is a very important. The flexibility play very important role in the life of early human. Growth in the size of the brain. The parameter to measure the brain, that is cranial capacity, CC. The growth in the size of the brain help for thinking, memorizing, planning and realizing to make new attempt for further development. It means the cranial capacity, if it increasing, it proved that the early human enabled to plan, to make a strategy, to make tools, and with the help of that, it changed their life. And visual surveillances improved in early human, it favored for long distance walking. Search food, find animal, and many more works. Next point, regional and replacement model. I explained regional and replacement model again and again in the 2 or 3 videos. In short, regional continuity model, the Homo sapiens originated in the different regions, continents, gradually evolved at different rates into the modern humans. And according to regional model, human being first originated in a single region, which is Africa, and migrated to all the other regions, continents. Both those who are supported the view take evidences of the genetic and anatomically homogeneity of modern human, such as 2 hands, 2 legs, 5 fingers, 2 eyes, 1 mouth, etc. The enormous similarity amongst modern human is due to their descent from the population that originated in the single region, which is Africa. Next point, early humans way of obtaining food. One video that is based on one topic. I was posted on APS portal. But again, I am explaining. It is helpful for you. Early humans way of obtaining food. Early humans would have obtaining food through a number of ways, such as gathering, hunting, scavenging, and fishing. Gathering would involve collection plant food such as seeds, nuts, berries, fruits and tubers. That gathering was practiced individually rather than collectively. Fossilized plants remains are the relatively rare, but plant remains that were accidentally born result in the colonization. In this form, द ऑर्गेनिक मैटर इज प्रिजर्व फॉर ए लॉन्ग स्पेन ऑफ टाइम टू फाइंड आउट एविडेंस फॉर फूड गैदरिंग बाय अर्ली ह्यूमन. द बायोलॉजिस्ट नो अबाउट दैट. दे कैन कलेक्ट द सीड्स एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट दे नो अबाउट दैट हाउ कैन इट वॉज प्रैक्टिस इन द ह्यूमन लाइफ. इट वॉज प्रैक्टिस इन नेचर. Hunting. Third, hunting probably began later about 5 lakh year ago. The earliest clear evidence for the deliberate planned hunting and butchery of large mammal comes from two sites. Box Grove in southern England and Songjen in Germany. We have two clear evidence, Songjen in Germany and Box Grove in southern England. Behalf of that, we can say that early human involved himself in hunting in a very vast level. In my video, I have already explained about the planned hunting. A place in Czech Republic where they assembled particular place, the river bank. They know that huge amount of animal uses the water of that river. We can very easily hunt at them, मार सकते हैं उनकी. वो इस बात को जानते थे. We have clear evidences. And increasingly, it is being suggested that the early hominids scavenged or foraged for meat and marrow from the carcasses of the animals that had died naturally or had been killed by other predators. It is equally possible that small mammals such as rodents, bird, their eggs, reptiles, and even insects were eaten by early hominids. Fishing was also important, as evident from the discovery of the fish bones at the different sites. Fishing was practiced from rivers, bones, and lakes with the hand, stone, and wood by the early human beings. It proved that fish were eaten by early humans because their remains part, it was used by early human as if weapons. हड्डियों को, मछलियों के कांटों को उन्होंने हथियारों के रूप में यूज किया. We have evidence that was dated from the England. Behalf of that, we can say that early human eat fish. Early human shelter patterns, residence of early humans. It means we are going to the topic early humans shelter. I have made a video particular that topic. If you will see, then you can get it properly. One way of reconstructing the evidence of pattern of the residence is by plotting the distribution of artifacts. Some places where food resources were abundant, humans visited repeatedly have more artifacts. In such areas, early human left behind a trace of their activities and presence. The place that were less frequently visited would have fewer artifacts. It is also important to remember that the first shelter was tree and which could have been shared by hominids, other primates and the carnivores. between 4 lakh to 1,25,000 years ago, the natural caves began to be used by them. Evidence for this comes from sites in Europe. In the Lézard Cave in southern France, a 12 into 4 meter shelter was built against the cave wall. Inside there were evidence of stone tools and food sources. At another site, Terra Amata, on the coast of southern France, flames shelters with roofs of wood and grasses were built for short-term seasonal visitors. Houses made of stone and baked clay and borne along with stone tools dated between 1.4 and 1 Maya have been found at Chiswanja, Kenya, and Swartkans, South Africa. On another hand, are indication of the controlled use of fire. This had the use of fire changed the human life. This had several advantages. Fire provided warmth and light inside cave and could be used for cooking. Besides, fire was used to harden wood, as for instance the tip of the spear. The use of heat also facilitated to the flaking of tools. The use of fire also facilitated human for the protection of the wild animal. Fire play very important role in human life. Fire, no doubt, it was the changing elements. It was the revolutionary elements in the human life. Early human making tools. The use of tools and tool making are not confined to human. Some chimpanzees use tools that they have made certain anatomically and neurologically related to the nervous system. Adaptation have led to skilled use the hand and fingers favored tool making by the early humans. Moreover, the way in which human use and make tools often require greater memory and complex organizing skill, both of which were present in human. The earliest evidence for the making and use of stone tools comes from sites in Ethiopia and Kenya. It is likely that earliest stone tool maker were the Homo habilis. We do not know whether tool making was done by men or women or both. It is possible that stone tool makers were both women and men. Women in particular may have made and used tools to obtain food for them as well as sustain their children after weaning. About 35,000 years ago, improvements in the technique for killing animals are evident from the appearance of the new kinds of tools such as spear, throwers, and the bow and arrow. That was the change. That was the new technology of the people introduced in human life during 35,000 years ago. That is a very important change. There were other needs, such as the trapping of fur-bearing animals to use the fur for clothing, and invention of sewing needles. The earliest evidence of sewing clothing comes from about 21,000 years ago. Besides, with the introduction of the punch blade technique to make small cheese-like tools, it was now possible to make engraving on bone antler ivory or wood. It means during 21,000 years ago, they started to sew cloth. They use cloth. We have evidence. Behalf of that, we are saying. Model of communication and language. There are several view of the languages development. The first use of language was the hominids. The hominids' languages involved the gesture or hand movement. Later, they developed another way of the communication known as the vocal but non-verbal communication, such as singing or humming. Homo habilis have the possessed a small number of speech sound in the initial stage. The gradually, these may have developed into language. It has been suggested that the brain of Homo habilis had certain features which would have made it possible to them to speak. Thus, language may have developed as early as Toumaya. The evolution of the vocal tress was equally important. This occurred around 2 lakh years ago. It is more specifically associated with the modern humans. That is a very important thing. This is time when man start to interact with each other with the help of vocal communication. First he started to the other things to interact with each other. Another suggestion is that language developed around the same time as art, that is around 4 lakhs to 35,000 years ago. 40,000 to 35,000 years ago, sorry. The development of spoken language has been seen as closely connected with art, since both are media or communication. If you will see, then you can find out. In my video, I have explained properly the communication system. And hunter-gatherer society, from the present to past, if you will see, the study of anthropologist. Now that time it is very bond matter that in the worldwide level, the various hunting and gathering societies is in existence. What is their importance in the prehistoric history? Can we know about their rituals, customs, their practices? And behalf of that, we can interrelate with the early humans to that tribal peoples.